Hundreds of youngsters converged on the Spalding Recreation Area of Mark Twain Lake Friday. And while there were games to be played, students were there to take advantage of the lake's many recreational opportunities. While outside their classrooms, Park Ranger Marianne Heitmeyer of the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers stressed that the children were still in a learning environment.
Well, today we've got our annual Environmental Education Day. We have approximately 500 students between 5th and 8th grade representing 11 area schools that are here today to learn about the environment and things that the agencies and organizations and businesses that are here with booths are doing to protect, promote, and enhance our natural environment. So ultimately, we're hoping to create tomorrow's, the next generation of environmental stewards for our natural resources.
It's an event Palmyra has been regularly coming to, according to Lynn Hillman, a fourth grade teacher at Palmyra Elementary School.
We've been taking our students here for over 5 years, and it just has fun activities that promote environmental issues, and it's very well organized, and the students always have lots of fun.
Among those on hand to provide information was Darrell Wenham of Alternate Power Systems.
I think we've really got them thinking about the different types of energy and the downfalls of each of them, and starting to realize that we are running out of natural resources and their generation's going to have to solve the problem.
It was not just adults providing instruction. Mark Twain High School sophomores Devin Berry and Haley Ackwright were on hand to teach about the recycling of paper. Both said they're becoming more environmentally conscious.
We're starting to be.
Yeah, we're both, after this year, we've started to recycle at home more.
Yeah, it's really easy to do, and I mean, anybody can do it, so it's really cool.
What important lesson is Grace Ferguson, a sixth grader from Monroe City, taking away from Environmental Education Day?
It's better to recycle than to waste.
For additional details, please see the accompanying online story or the Saturday, September 20th edition of the Hannibal Courier-Post. For the Courier-Post, I'm Danny Henley reporting.